an 89-year history ended in a very, very bizarre way.
Good people.
They fell all the way to the ground.
There's been a lot of murders.
You can feel the evil.
Killed instantly.
Keep talking to me, please. Guys, please, I'm hearing noises. I don't know where I am.
Okay, you have to go. I'm going down the stairs now. Go downstairs to the main lobby.
My name is Jesse.
My name is Amy.
I live in Revere, Massachusetts. It's about 5 minutes away from Boston.
And I'm originally from Durham, Maine.
My name is Jennifer. I'm 19 years old.
I'm Heidi. I'm from Portland.
My name is Michael Anthony.
I think that the six of us will be put in an allegedly haunted house.
And today I'm going to be an expert at paranormalology.
One of my jobs here on life is to make people happy and to fight evil and to stop it whenever I can.
I'm definitely a leader.
I may cry a little bit.
I'm scared already.
I do believe in ghosts.
I do not rely on God to protect me.
There is a devil.
You guys, please, I'm hearing noises.
Not a scaredy cat.
Can't tell you. Okay, hey, I'm going down the main lobby now.
Just go in there and do it.
I don't want to do this.
Do it.
Bring it on! Bring it on!
Stepping on your roses and pissing on your daisies, man!
Peer pressure's a
bitch. That's it for now. Hi.
Michael.
Michael, Amy. Welcome to Buck Hill Inn. As you're facing the inn, to your left is a brown building.
Is that it?
That's gotta be it.
Chief, we found the furniture stacked to the ceiling in 354. The maids will no longer clean in the room. I recommend sealing the room.
Ooh, 354?
Yeah, I'm not going in there.
What's the next step say? Click the mouse on the fear thing.
Yeah, double click on fear and see what it gives us.
Begin your stay by going to the video page.
Welcome to the Buck Hill Inn. Established in 1901. The inn was open for 85 years before abruptly closing its doors after the owner's wife went insane.
Mr. Keeler drove her to a local hospital, checked her into the psychiatric ward, and announced to the staff that he was closing the hotel. All the guests checked out, and that was it. Beds were made, there were towels in the bathroom, bars of soap. It really appeared to be frozen in time.
It's like nothing. I mean, it's like dead. I mean, there always used to be so much activity, the light, the people.
For decades, the inn has been notorious for extreme paranormal activity.
I had a guest come up and ask me, do you have ghosts in your hotel?
She woke up one night to a weird voice. She couldn't understand it. Her bed started shaking.
My security guard was laying on the floor. His head was pretty much caved in. He had been beaten with a meat mallet.
The spirit tends to want to hang around to project evil energy onto someone because this is what they did in the lifetime.
During your stay at Buck Hill, your mission is to determine if the hotel is haunted.
This computer will lead you through your investigation with a series of dares.
Your investigation will take you to 5 locations where paranormal activity has been reported. Room number 61 in the servants' quarters. The men's room in the basement of the hotel. Room 354 in the west wing. The main lobby and the east room.
When the dare is accomplished, and only when it's fully accomplished, inform the computer. Now find the black bag on the fireplace mantle.
Pick a colored patch from the bag and enter it into the website.
You will be identified by these colors throughout the dare instructions.
Iris gets green.
To complete your investigation successfully, you must abide by three key rules. 1. Use your camera equipment to document your experiences at all times. 2. Follow the instructions on this website exactly in your investigation. 3. You may quit at any time. However, if you fail to complete a dare, you forfeit your prize money, and another team member must complete your assignment.
Nobody's doing that.
No. If you complete all of your dares, you win $5,000. Begin your investigation now.
Let's do it. Dare 1. Find sleeping bags and staff.
That's
purple.
Me.
Purple will enter the hotel and proceed to room 61 in the servants' quarters to retrieve ghost hunting equipment.
It was quite a struggle getting one of the housekeepers to go in there.
1 minute something's there and the next minute it's not.
Knocks on the walls and rooms next door that the TV goes up and down and up and down, but there's nobody in the room.
Are you up for this?
You want to take some water with you?
Oh, there you go. That'll be good. I don't know where I am. I'm really scared.
Guys, please, I'm hearing noises. This is not funny. Make sure all your lights are working.
Right, which 100%, right?
Yeah.
Okay, what the?
Nothing's gonna happen.
We're right here for which way do I go? I go that way.
What do I do?
Okay, this is what you're gonna do. You're gonna exit the safe house, proceed to the left, and into the first level of the several laundry rooms.
I'm in the laundry rooms. Okay. I see the washroom. I just walked through the laundry room. I see a sign that says washroom.
Walk right across to the far end of this room. Go through this door.
To the staff quarters. Yeah, I'm on the third floor.
Okay, you need to find room 61, or you'll find the bag of ghost hunting equipment.
I'm going through another hallway now. Please let this be 61. 85. There's no 61 here. But now I'm at another doorway. Okay, I'm going back. I'm going through another doorway. 61. Hold on, I'm in 61.
You need to find, you will find a bag of ghost hunting equipment. Wait there, okay?
I got it. Please tell me really quickly. Do 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 do.
On this floor, several staff members have confirmed seeing a ghost of an older man in an old-fashioned military uniform. No one knows who he is or when he died.
I had a guest come up and ask me, do you have ghosts in your hotel? I said, no, why? She said, well, I have someone stand at the bottom of my bed at night. She says, I know. She says, it's a man.
But it was a gentleman dressed in a military garb of way back when. And it was like a real strange feeling to have him there and then have him nowhere.
To complete your dare, take the equipment and return the safe house.
Okay.
$5,000. Just turn around and walk all the way back.
Keep talking to me, please. I don't know how to get out. I don't know where I am. I don't know where I am. Hold on, I'm scared. Really scared. It says 1. Do I go down another one? I'm scared. Okay. Scared as but. Oh my gosh.
You rock.
Oh.
Nice, look at you.
You are
stunning. You are my hero.
All right. Oh,
my
okay?
Inspiration. Where would I be without your
voice? Are you okay, baby?
I do not know.
Was it really scary in there?
If I can do it, anyone can do it, seriously.
No, you don't know how scared I am.
Blue.
Oh, so we're behind you 100%.
Why don't we read this first and see where we're going?
Blue will collect the EMF trimeter and proceed to the basement men's room to investigate paranormal activity.
No!
My security guards had sustained an injury. I rushed up there, and my security guard was laying on the floor. He had been beaten with a meat mallet. His head was pretty much caved in on the one side. And there was blood all over the place.
Wait, can someone say the Lord's Prayer with me real quick?
Yeah. Our Father who art in
heaven, hallowed be thy name. Kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Oh my God, I'm so scared. It's dark in here.
Turn right and walk down a short hallway.
That's where I am right now.
Back in this tunnel, there's also a man that was beaten to death right around in this area. It's right in here that he was killed. They beat him to death.
The tunnel will take you to a sharp left and lead to a staircase. Walk up the stairs. At the top of these stairs, turn left and take another quick left.
Okay, I'm right in front of the two exit sign.
Turn left and follow the hall till you see a door marked employees only.
Hold on. Hello?
Are you all right?
It says employees only. Where do I go?
Go through this employees door and turn immediately right. You are now in the basement men's room.
And what do I do after that?
You're going to have to take some electromagnetic readings. Aberration spectres and other supernatural presence emit electromagnetic radiation into the atmosphere. The EMF trimeter is an instrument that detects and measures the level of spirit energy. You must maintain radio silence for the next 10 minutes during this time. You'll use your EMF trimeter to take readings throughout the entire room. Your time begins now. You will be notified when your 10 minutes are up.
Can you talk to me throughout this whole thing?
I can't.
It's radio silence, so the 10 minutes
goes now.
Okay, I'm starting now, okay?
Here we go.
It's okay, Spirit. I'm sorry what happened to you. I believe in God. I am a Christian. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
A spirit can attack a person. You don't know it's coming. You're not prepared for it.
There are as many evil spirits as there are good spirits.
Just how many minutes? I'm not gonna say a word.
You guys.
She's probably thought she's been in there for an hour.
Yeah. You guys, please, I'm hearing noises. This is not f***ing funny.
I can't tell you. It's radio silence.
She's hearing noises?
Radio silence.
Look, I ran. Oh, if I get disqualified, I don't care. The camera fell off. I ran. My black ass. Off.
Hey, for future reference, guys, radio silence means you get way too iconic. The person.
I understand
navigator.
That, but when I heard the noise, that's why I freaked out, because.
You can't go back?
You sure? Wait, let's think about it. You guys, I was shaking. I kept trying to check my cam. I was shaking. Look, I can't do it.
You gotta pick someone else to go in your place.
Don't you dare pick me, girl.
I'll go.
You gotta
be going twice then, you know.
Yeah.
Fear overcomes all. It freaked me the hell out. It wasn't worth it.
I want to go home, so I'm out.
At the employees only door.
Go through this employees only door and turn immediately right.
You're in the basement men's room.
You could get this feeling, you'd catch something out of the corner of your eye. 1 minute something's there and the next minute it's not.
You must maintain radio silence for the next 10 minutes
during this time.
Showtime, baby. What's up?
All right, he's been in there 6 minutes. A little under, 5 and a half.
The commode seats go up and down. Something bad is here.
Bring it on! Bring it on! I don't see no horror! Huh? I got my EKG, bitch! Nothing.
Hey, dude, move.
You're done, dude.
Is this still there?
Tactless.
Coming home, baby. Coming home.
All right, come on back.
Yo, the CKG thing's going off like a bastard all around these parts, man.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
They're completed.
I'm doing good, actually.
You want to shut the camera off?
Yeah, there is definitely something going on in there.
Beef, cash, beef, ass.
Definitely something going on in there.
Yeah, but let's get the pipes.
Here we go.
This stair is for Red. Green will navigate.
Red, I'm out.
You're not going to go?
No way.
At all?
After seeing those last two? No. Mm-mm.
Wow.
There's no way I want to do this at 4:40 in the morning, you know?
This is just a little too crazy for my brain. The dares just kept getting harder. $5,000 though, it's a lot of money. But I just can't do that extra plunge.
Dude, it is kind of trying. It is kind of trying, I have to say that, you know?
What are you thinking? The only girl left.
I've always liked those odds though.
You know what? Why don't we just take it one step at a time? I'm gonna click on this.
Dare 3. Orange will complete the mission aborted by Red. Orange will collect the bridal photo and proceed to room 354 in the west wing of the hotel.
And there are some nasty spirits here, especially when you get upstairs. You could just feel the evil.
So you might hear footsteps, hear voices, a door might creak. You'll hear something going up the steps and there's no one there.
Remember, you may use a safety on this dare.
A safety is a team member that will accompany a fellow team member for part of a particular dare. We're allowed to use a safety only two dares.
If you want a safety, dude, we'll go. Someone will go out there.
Yeah.
This probably is not going to be as scary as another dare we have to do in the future. So to get past this one, we might need a safety later on.
You're not going to need a safety to go all the way down.
So you got it, dude.
You feeling me? Good. Close that door behind me, yo.
Hey guys, man, y'all can't pep talk me. Damn it, man, I can't do this, man.
All right, take deep breaths. Take deep breaths, you're all set. Just keep talking to me.
Hey guys.
Yeah?
Time alert, day one is completed. This dare will be reattempted tomorrow. Please return to call page.
I'm begging out. I'm out, I'm out, I'm out, I'm out, I'm out.
Woo, day one is over.
Woo!
over.
Good deal, man.
Just before you're about to make the biggest mistake of your life.
You're probably right.
Good deal.
Now I got time to rectify this and think on how I'm going to rectify this.
I'm glad. Thank you guys.
A team sticking together.
Yeah.
A team sticking together.
Okay, Mike is going on our first dare of the second night, and he has Jesse as his safety.
Don't forget to take the photo.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Bye, guys.
Go out the safe house door, turn left, follow the path, and go into the basement of the staff quarters building.
We have just reached the lower lobby.
From the lower lobby, take the wide staircase to your left up to the main floor.
Whoa. Confirming reaching top of main staircase, need more instruction or over.
The safety will now wait in the corridor of arches in the main lobby.
Staircase. Turn to your immediate left and walk about 15 steps. Go up the stairs to the third floor. Turn right
down the third floor hallway.
You must now find room 354.
Round 354.
Stop and confirm you have successfully made it into room 354.
Have opened door to room 354.
All right, here are your instructions.
Give them to me fast.
You are now in room 354. This was also Lorna Kilpatrick's room, where she prepared for her wedding, applying makeup and putting on her wedding dress. Staff and psychics agree that Lorna's ghost still haunts this room today.
Just put the picture on the desk.
Lay out the dress of Lorna on the
bed. You will find the wedding dress in the closet.
Finding the wedding dress now.
Lay out the dress on the bed. And then kneel down on the pillow on the floor.
I am now kneeling on pillow. I hope y'all watch it for me.
This was the very position that Lorna was told to take by her priest before he bashed in her skull with a hammer from behind.
This is unexplainable that this man, a man of the Lord, could have done something as horrendous as this. After they found the body, he went in his vehicle and killed himself.
You must stay in the kneeling position and pay respect to the ghost of Lorna.
You must maintain radio silence and are not allowed to look behind you, or else you will forfeit the dare. The website will notify the navigator when you can return to the safe house.
Starting radio silence now.
Time to go to war, kid.
Sick.
This was the very position that Lorna was told to take by the priest before he
passed. Have seen if their spirits are still here at the end.
In her skull with a hammer from behind.
And killed himself. You can feel the evil.
Yo, your time is up. Get up and get the hell out of there.
Boo! Leave the third floor right now. Ah! Oh, God! Oh, God!
He is so awesome.
Yo, Mike! I hear you, baby.
Good job, man. Good job.
Maybe he's just gonna be like, whatever.
For the next one, I bet he is. Because if he can do that, he can do anything.
Mm-hmm.
Moving down tunnel now, returning home.
Confirm.
Excellent!
Woo!
Woo!
Good.
How was that, yo?
I would have stir crazy if I wouldn't have had him as a safety dude.
You were sitting in the room, kneeling down in the position that Lorna, whatever name was.
Got her brains bashed in.
Yeah, that's getting cold, dude. I didn't know what that was.
Good job.
You are so awesome.
Yeah, that was breaking.
You
that
are
was
so
awesome,
awesome,
dude.
Purple, collect the exorcism kit and proceed to the east room where you'll perform an exorcism. Yellow will be your safety.
Hey, what's up with this?
The East Room is believed to be a vortex for spirits.
A vortex is almost like a magnet that will draw spirits in. You could have hundreds and hundreds.
When you enter into a high concentration vortex, it will accentuate the emotional responses.
I want to go home.
Candle. This is the whole kit.
Once you get out there, you'll be okay.
Grab that door.
Right away. You have it?
Yeah. Yep, I got it. Are you good, Heidi?
No.
We can do this. Be strong. Tell them we're at the stairs.
We're at the stairs.
The top of the stairs, take a left, and then another quick
turn,
left,
Heidi.
And you will see
a two exit sign directly
in front of you with an arrow pointing right. Stop there,
deep breath,
and then confirm your location.
Hold on. We got this. We got this. Grab my hand. Here we go.
I hate this.
Tell them we're at the two exit sign.
We're at the two exit sign.
Jesse, you have to give Heidi the box and go back to the washroom junction.
No, no. No, 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 no. I don't want to do this. I really don't.
All right, we can walk back. Do you want to walk back?
I think I do.
Can you do this?
I don't think I can.
Then you want to go back?
I think I do.
All right.
We're coming back.
All right, confirmed.
I can't do this exorcism. I cannot do that.
It's all right. It's all right.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Don't worry about what's it say next?
I don't look
get to the next step, guys.
Heidi, you're purple, right?
Yeah.
Are you sure you want to quit and give up your $5,000? Absolutely.
Purple.
Well, yeah.
You did good.
Thank you for coming with me.
You're welcome.
The one thing that just freaks me out is, like, exorcisms. It's not worth it to me to freak out and just go crazy or something. So, that's it. I'm going home.
I am at the staircase.
On your right, you will see a set of double glass pane white doors.
Go through these doors,
walk straight, and enter the east room.
I am in the room with lamps, the east room.
You are now in the east room, a massive hall that contains a powerful evil energy that controls the entire hotel.
And there are some nasty spirits here, and you can't get rid of it. It's there.
Walk past all the lamps to the end of the room until you find a clearing in which there is a large metal bowl on the ground. In the bowl is a piece of paper upon which is written in Latin an exorcism used by a Catholic priest to combat evil.
I'm waiting for instruction.
Splash the holy water on the ground so that it encircles where you stand. Then drink some of it. Then read the text aloud over the radio and hope that it works.
nomes de partes de filius et des spiritus sanctus
amius vocre et
spiritus sanctus terra santa inter dicera.
Now, to make sure exorcism is complete, radio silence must be maintained for 15 minutes from this point on.
If a person ends up performing an exorcism and they're not trained to do so, you will end up in a situation where the spirit could attach itself.
Dude, this is pretty fat what they've been doing. This is pretty fat.
He's taking this like a champ, dude. Alright, come home now. 15 minutes are up.
That was tough. What happened?
Phil, I was like in there for 3 hours, dude.
I'm all shaking and stuff now.
Did you say they're completed?
Yeah, I did that.
Did you say next there?
The bodyguard in your head for stepping on your roses and pissing on your daisies, man!
There five. Orange will proceed to room 354 in the west wing of the hotel and await further instructions.
I ain't going back up there to Liberty Boy, dude. I'm not even up to 354. I ain't going back up there. Dude. There's a wedding dress on the bed. There's about 5 or 6 open rooms.
Why don't you just go and check it out and do the dare, and then you, once you go and check it out, then you can leave, dude.
Yeah, I ain't going back up there.
Dude, don't f*** us like
no,
this,
come on, man.
That's bullshit, man.
I'm performing an exorcism. I was thinking about you guys.
Hey, now. Back of my skull with a hammer in that room already once. Now they want me to go in there and do the exact same thing with
no, they're gonna yes, make they you are. Just record stuff, dude.
I don't want to go back up in 354.
Dude, do what you have to do.
Somebody open the door. Open.
Your money.
Somebody open the door.
I got the door. Bro.
Do it. All right. I don't know if I can do this.
All right, brother, you can do it.
I didn't want to leave. I can leave.
Go, man. Go.
You know exactly where the room is. Just
you know
remember.
Right where the room is.
Whoa.
All right, brother, you can do it.
Hey, open the door, y'all.
Go, man. Go.
You know exactly where the room is. Just
know exactly where the room is.
I got a mental break, dude. I can't go with it.
This is the most disappointing day of my life.
You got this under control.
I've never locked up like this before.
This is within your capabilities. This is within your limits. There's no room for fear. All you have to do is do a simple sequence of actions. Walk here. Just all you have to do is think about walking where you have to walk when you have to walk there.
Yeah, but I already did it, man.
So do it again.
354.
Yes,
354, they've already got in your head, man. They're in there. They're stomping around. They're stepping on your roses and pissing on your daisies, man.
This is a load of whore.
Open the damn door, man. I got to...
Yeah!
See me post it on the radio.
Right. Yep. We got your back, dude. You're all set. You're all set, my friend.
Room. Staff and psychics agree that Lorna's ghost still haunts this room today. This was also Lorna Kilpatrick's room.
Once inside
room 354, make your way to the bathroom and
open the door. I'm going to read you something quick and just, you know, concentrate. One of the many deaths in this room was that of
a maid named Monique Welton. In August 1964, her body was found lying in the cold water of this tub
with her wrist slash and her blood everywhere. No one knows why.
I don't know why so many people are stuck here, except there's a lot of emotional stuff going on.
It's physical energy. This is the only way they know to get your attention.
Right, Mike, you must sit in the bathroom for 5 minutes without opening the shower curtain in complete silence starting now.
Thank you.
I just don't want to sit somewhere again for that long, dude. Why couldn't you have done this before? I don't know.
Most suicide attempts are too weak to actually complete the act, so they allow the spirit to just enter them. They channel it.
All right, the 5 minutes are up. Orange, reach into the murky water of the tub to find something that belonged to Monique long ago.
All right. Oh, I think it's a rosary, dude.
Whoa, noises, kiddo.
You might hear footsteps, a door might creak.
You have the item from the tub.
Holding in my hand a rosary. These are rosary beads found clutched in Monique's cold, dead hand. Once you have the beads, you may return to the safe house.
Woo! Okay, whoa, going down the hall, okay, going down the hall, you hear me, kid?
Calm yourself. Take a deep breath, all right?
You know what? You can't get that stuff, man, to do it. Just walk.
You hear something going up the steps, and there's no one there.
Going out there right now. Oh,
I'm scared. Oh, my God. I'm scared as hell. Hey, okay. I'm going down the stairs. I'm in the royal lobby now. Oh, God.
Take it easy.
I'm not going down, dude. I'm going down the stairs, okay? I'm cool.
Whatever you do, don't get hurt, okay?
Oh! And I'm headed down the door, the tunnel. I'm at the tunnel now. Oh my God, I'm walking down the tunnel. Goodness, making a left, okay? Talk to me.
All right, I'm talking to you, buddy. You're almost out of there.
Okay. I'm so cool right now, okay? You know me.
All right, you're coming in, man.
Awesome.
It was not cool.
All right. You're still alive, right?
Acting stupid.
You're still alive?
Doesn't matter. Confidence is shot.
Confidence? Okay. Confidence should be 110%.
Broken down in so many ways, you don't even understand.
Man. One more dare left.
Yeah, I'm paranoid. Look at this thing, yo.
What? It's
all of us.
Your final dare of the evening is a group dare.
Grab the two envelopes sitting on the shelf in your safe house. Do not open
either envelope. You must venture into the hotel one last time to earn your money.
Basement crossroads to the two-legged sign. And when you reach that point, you may open the first envelope and follow the instructions. All right, dudes.
Bounce.
It's lock and load. Just follow me, bro.
Shot and true, baby.
Everyone still with us?
Right behind.
Andy?
Check, I'm here.
First envelope. Go up the staircase with immediately behind you. To the top of the stairs left, you're now in the kitchen. All right, we're going to the kitchen.
Oh, snap.
We gotta cross from the center of the kitchen. Left, guys, left, this way.
Alright, follow us. Here we go.
I guess this way, guys. There'll be a passageway immediately left.
Right, we're there.
I guess this is it.
Alright, we're going to the vault.
Open the giant vault door. Inside the vault will be a small safe. Remove the item and open envelope 2.
Oh, that's a vault.
Yeah.
Hey, dude, you going there solo, good man, don't you? Need?
Yeah, watch out. What do you got?
Oh. All right, read envelope 2.
Congratulations, you successfully confronted your fear.
It'd be a small safe.
Get in there, man. That's real money. The money you are holding is part of your reward for completing your dares. You may now return to the safe house.
Oh my God, dude.
Is there a bunch of money in there?
Dude, we're done!
Done.
All money, dude.
All money.
I wanted to throw up. I was so scared. You don't even know the tricks your mind plays on you. I hated it. I dealt with it.
Oh, wow. I'm coming home. Cash flow.
With a fistful of ones.
I guess as far as last night is concerned,
It was pretty scary, but I just try to take it at face value. You know, go in there, do my job, do it. That doesn't mean I don't have to be scared about it. I am. I'm just ready to go.
How you feeling right now? Woo! Dude, I'm taking all my...
It's definitely the most harrowing experience of my young life. I'm glad that I didn't cop out, you know, I didn't quit even though I really wanted to. You know, I kind of feel like I can do anything, you know, take on the whole wide world if I need to. And don't ever go into room 334. I'm telling you, there's something in that room.
On the next Fear.
The walls of Eastern State Penitentiary could talk and scream.
You must cinch this strap up tight and buckle it behind the neck.
Hold on, dude. The rat just crawled up my boot onto my leg.
Start walking now. You're running out of time.
Dude, don't leave.
I have to get back.
Then I'm stuck in here.
Trust me, I'll come back.
Promise me, man.
I'll come back.
Shereen!
Can you guys hear me? You guys, I can't see.
Oh my gosh!
Oh my god!
I don't know how to get out. I don't know where I am. I don't know where I am. Hold on, I'm scared. I'm really scared.
Bring it on! Bring it on!
KG, bitch!
Blast the holy water on the ground so that it encircles where you stand. Then drink some of it. Then read the text aloud.
In numis de patris, de spilius, et de spiritus sanctus, amnius, vocre, et spiritus sanctus, terra santa.
Oh! Oh god! Oh god!
I'm cool.
Whatever you do.